I'm Colonel Joseph Mickley. I'm the commander for 2nd Battalion, 4th SFAB, and we're here as the lead OCT team for the 4th SFAB Valex for the next force package, Force Package 25-1. They're here training, and so what they're doing is they're running through all their specific advisor tasks in a real-world environment here at JRTC to prepare for upcoming deployments. All their systems are being stressed from the battalion level down to the individual advisor teams here at JRTC, both through real world and through simulated injects in a simulation that provides them the ability 360 to look at themselves, conduct their training objectives, and really gives them a hard look in a advisor role in a conflict scenario.
So this validation exercise for the SFAB here at JRTC is a little unique and a little different because of the nature of our unit and our mission. So the role players that we're interacting with are replicating a division of a foreign security force with their subordinate brigades, and the mission of this battalion is to enter that country, engage with a partner, and then bring to bear, you know, coalition, US, NATO, allied resources in the defense of their sovereign nation.
Yeah, JRTC or any CTC rotation allows any unit, in this case, the Force Package for 4th SFAB, to alert marshal to deploy several hundred, in this case, thousands of miles away from their home station, which is their sustainment base. So it already sets them up for an opportunity to practice their doctrinal sustainment capabilities away from where they would be pretty easily accessible to everything that they've had their creature conference, which replicates a real world employment or deployment for sustainers. And what's unique about coming away from home station is that our sustainment advisors have to both simultaneously stress their sustainment enterprise in a partner and allied environment. And what I mean by that is most sustainers can go to a theater sustainment enterprise and generally get whatever they want. And then in this particular case, that theater sustainment enterprise is prioritized potentially to US forces that are inflowing into a theater based on crisis and into conflict. So advisors really have to be creative and entrepreneurial on how they're gonna not only sustain themselves from getting on ground to integrating with a partner force, but also how do they provide sustainment effects in support of that partner or ally as we transition from crisis into potential conflict.
The challenge before these specific advisors is managing the relationship with their partner, as well as bringing to bear their knowledge and expertise within their warfighting function, particularly the US doctrine, and our ability to conduct planning and co-ops simultaneously. For my advisors specifically, they were heavily engaged in the planning of a combined arms defense, right, with both conventional and scatterable mines, you know, conventional anti-tank and defensive obstacles. And then through the counterattack, the breaching and mobility assurance of the force moving forward across a battlefield that, you know, frankly, doesn't have the same technological advantages that our military has gotten used to.
So yeah, our team here, the OCT team, looks at almost every aspect of the advisors conducting their mission. So we have the benefit from seeing them from the very first day that they're here in RSOI through all the various scenario challenges that they encounter. We are here providing feedback to the force package, force package command team, force package leaders, and then the individual teams. So yesterday we conducted a mid-row AAR where we were able to apprise them of the lessons that we've seen them encounter so far up into this point in the scenario, provide them the ability to lead themselves through an AAR, focus on the things that they want to fix, and identify who's going to fix the challenges they've encountered, and then who would inspect those fixes that they make. So helping the team get better for the remaining battle period that they're out here, focusing on internal lessons learned.
JRTC is a great look for us. We always seek to see ourselves so we can learn, grow, and improve as an organization, as a battalion, and as a SFAB in general. So the JRTC experience is really good because it's putting the pressure on us, on the systems that we've developed over the foundation and collective phases of training over the past 6 and 7 months respectively, to be able to prepare for this rotation. So we've had things that we've developed as a standard operating procedures that we've developed in garrison. Now we're testing them out in the field and seeing what works, what doesn't work. We're starting with the SFAC tax op as sort of a baseline for planning products, and then we're putting them to use out here in the JRTC environment. And so what's great about that is we get to see our ability to advise at the division level and more specifically see where our gaps are and see where we need to go back to the manuals or use our advisor reach back to gather some information we don't necessarily have. So for example, the division commander's asking me a lot about our doctrinal terms, and so I'm able to go over to 5-0 and look up the planning process that our Army uses and help them through how specifically each step works, and then back to our operational terms and graphics to more precisely define what an attack is, what a seizure is, what a clear is, and those tactical tasks have meaning in our Army, they have meaning in their Army. And so while we might not have the answer at the time, we can certainly look back at the manuals we have, and we can ask our higher headquarters to fill in those gaps that we don't necessarily have on the spot.